Let's talk about the pros and cons of living in Barcelona, Spain. Hi guys, welcome back to a new video. I lived in Barcelona for 5 months from September 2018 until January 2019. And in this video, I want to talk about the good and bad of living in Barcelona. To make sure I wouldn't forget anything important, I also asked my friend Vilma for her opinions. Me and Vilma actually moved together to Barcelona. We studied at the same university here in Finland and also in Barcelona. But in Barcelona, we did live with 5 other roommates from Sweden and the Netherlands. So let's begin with the less positive stuff, the cons of living in Barcelona. So living in Barcelona can be very loud, especially if you're not used to it. I lived in the city center of Barcelona, just a few hundred meters from La Rambla, and at times it was so loud. So what I mean by it being loud is that sometimes there were protests going on, some kind of rallies and that kind of things, some kind of sound of maintenance and repairs, you know, drilling sound. And a drilling sound can get so annoying so quickly. And of course it's good that they are maintaining and also repairing the old buildings that are in Barcelona, but you know, living in the middle of that sound could be very annoying at times. Another negative thing about living in Barcelona is the amount of tourists. There are so many tourists in Barcelona, and it doesn't really matter what time of year it is, there's a lot of tourists all the time. And of course, tourism is an important part of the economy in Barcelona, but at times it could be very annoying to, you know, live in a city with so many tourists. And sometimes it was very difficult to get from place A to place B because of the tourists. Tourists were blocking the streets of Barcelona, especially if you live in the city center of Barcelona as we did. And tourists, of course, they look at things and they're kind of just enjoying what they see, and they're just walking so slowly. So if I would ever move to Barcelona again or visit Barcelona, I would probably stay in a more quieter area, a bit more further away from La Rambla and like the really the city center of Barcelona, just to get away from the amount of tourists and just to get a bit more peaceful place. And for example, El Poblenou is a neighborhood that I really came to like when I was staying in Barcelona. It was still in the city center, very close to everything, but just a bit more outside of La Rambla, and I just liked it because it was more quiet but still, you know, easy to get everywhere. So another thing I noticed while living in Barcelona is that there's a lot of homeless people, and I think this is just one of those things that you kind of have to get used to if you live in a big city like Barcelona. So there are a lot of tourists and there are also a lot of homeless people. And oh my god, the amount of pigeons in the city, it's unbelievable how many pigeons there are in Barcelona. I can't understand it. I can't wrap my head around it. It's crazy. I know this sounds so weird, but there's just so many pigeons in Barcelona. And this is a thing that I have like never thought about complaining about, but pigeons. So Plaza de Catalunya and the surroundings are just full of pigeons, and with the tourists there blocking the streets, it's just really hard to go anywhere without being hit by a pigeon or by a tourist. I don't know, this is a weird thing to be complaining about, but it's just something that really got to annoy me when I was living in Barcelona, because I was living so close to Plaza de Catalunya. And a fun story about the pigeons. So when me and Vilma were walking to the metro station in the mornings around like 7 or 8 a.m. to catch the train to university, which was located outside of Barcelona, there was this old lady who were walking down the streets in the area, and she was feeding the pigeons. She was just, you know, throwing out a lot of bird seeds. So of course the pigeons are gonna be there if there's a lot of bird seed there. But she was just, every morning she was walking around the streets in the area and just throwing so much bird seeds all over the place. So another negative thing about Barcelona is that the rent can be very expensive. So it can be very difficult to find an affordable place to live. We wanted to stay in the city center of Barcelona instead of at the campus, because as I already mentioned, the university that we both attended was it was far away from the city center, and we definitely did want to, you know, take it all in and just stay in the city center of Barcelona. And it was very difficult to find an affordable place to live. And something to be aware about is that the
there are quite a lot of scammers out there in Barcelona that try to, you know, sell an apartment to you, or not sell, but sell the idea that they have this apartment, which they don't, and then they have you pay a deposit, like a rent deposit or something like that, in advance, and then the apartment doesn't even exist. So we were quite afraid of this happening to us, so we were really careful to find something reliable, and in the end we did find a place really close to La Rambla, so really great location for two exchange students, but it can be very difficult. So for example, my tiny room that didn't even have a window cost 450 euros a month. Let's keep in mind that this was in an apartment with 7 people living in it, so me plus 6 others, and I paid 450 euros for my tiny room without a proper window, and my roommates paid around 500 to 700 euros for their rooms. So very expensive. However, we were lucky enough to have weekly cleaning, so there was this cleaning lady who came to clean our common spaces each week. She didn't really clean them that well, but at least we didn't have to do it, so that's what's nice. So another negative thing about Barcelona and living in Barcelona is the tap water. Basically, you can drink the tap water, but it doesn't taste very good. And I just didn't want to, you know, take the risk of getting sick of the tap water. So I just bought water from the stores. And that's just one thing that I really miss about Finland when I was living in Barcelona, because the tap water in Finland is very fresh and very good. Yeah, that's just one small negative thing but something I still wanted to mention. So the last bad thing I want to mention about Barcelona is that there's a lot of pickpockets, so thieves that try to steal your stuff. I'm sure this does not come as a surprise to anybody if you have read anything about Barcelona. There's so much pickpocketing happening in Barcelona. I mean, if you have ever been there, if you have ever read about Barcelona, this is one thing that you definitely shouldn't have missed. Luckily, I didn't get pickpocketed, but I do know plenty of people who did. So there were a lot of stolen phones, wallets, purses, and even laptops were stolen. So, you know, just be careful if you're ever traveling to Barcelona or if you're moving there, because you definitely have to be careful and watch out for your belongings at all times. Now, let's move on to the fun stuff, the pros about living in Barcelona. So firstly, Barcelona is the perfect combination of beach and city. So if you're someone who is looking to have both the city life and the beach life in one package, then Barcelona is perfect for that. The beach is literally in the city, or the city is at the beach. So, you know, it's very close. And even though I do think that Barceloneta is a nice beach, I do prefer the less crowded beaches over Barceloneta. Barceloneta is like the main beach of Barcelona, so there's always a lot of people there, a lot of tourists, and also a lot of pickpocketers, so look out for those. But if you walk alongside the beachfront, you will definitely find some more quieter and also less crowded beaches close to Barceloneta. Some of the beaches that I really enjoyed going to were located in El Poblenou, so the neighborhood that I already mentioned, and there you can find some more quieter and less crowded beaches. Another good thing about living in Barcelona is that it's a very international city and English is widely spoken. So you can definitely survive in Barcelona without knowing any Spanish or Catalan. So if you know English, you'll be good, because I don't speak Spanish or Catalan at all. So I know how to get around in a supermarket, I know how to ask where the bathroom is, and those kind of like basic stuff, but I wish I would speak Spanish better, but I don't. And I got along fine in Barcelona, so will you. So this next thing is definitely one of my favorite things about Barcelona, and that's the food. Oh, let's talk about the food. So Barcelona is filled with delicious food. Of course, we have the tapas, we have other Spanish dishes, and also like international cuisine. So if you're looking for some tacos, maybe some vegan burgers, maybe some, you know, other stuff, you can find it in Barcelona. There's a lot of different food places and very good food in general. But when you go to a restaurant in Barcelona, don't go to one at La Rambla, because those are most likely very touristy and also more expensive. So you'll find better and more affordable options when you go a bit outside of La Rambla. And I think this is a thing with a lot of bigger cities
in the world in general, if you're going to a place where there are a lot of tourists, somewhere very central, you'll probably end up in a restaurant which is just more expensive and lower quality than if you would just explore the restaurants a bit outside the center. And of course, there's a lot of good tapas places in Barcelona which you should definitely check out. My favorite was Bodega Vasconia because we lived very close to Bodega Vasconia and they had very good tapas and at affordable prices, and also the owners and the staff there was just so lovely and atmosphere was really good. So I really loved going to Bodega Vasconia and I do recommend it for anyone who wants to eat good tapas in Barcelona. And of course there's a lot of other restaurants in Barcelona, for example Rosa del Raval, which has really good tacos and margaritas and also other Mexican food. And then we have Cat Bar, which has the most delicious vegan burgers that I have ever tasted. They were so good, so good. And I do definitely recommend all of these. So if you're in Barcelona, go check out Bodega Vasconia, Rosa del Raval and Cat Bar. So the next perk about living in Barcelona is definitely the weather. The weather is mostly nice in Barcelona. They have a lot of sunny days of the year. I say mostly nice because of course, as in any other place or almost any other place, it can rain sometimes. And when it rains in Barcelona, it can rain like a lot. But Barcelona is mostly sunny and quite warm in the winters too, especially if you compare the winters in Barcelona to the Finnish winters, because in Barcelona it can be around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius in the winter time, and summers are very hot in Barcelona. But I did find September and October be a lovely month when it comes to weather in Barcelona. And we did even go to the beach in October, in late October, early November even. So the next thing I want to mention is that Barcelona has very good public transportation. So the public transportation system is very good in Barcelona and you can get to most places by train or metro or bus. Both buses and metro work really well. I usually use the metro because I was just more used to it as I used it to go to uni every day, but also the buses work really well even late at night. I think they work like all night long, depending on the day, of course. So another thing about Barcelona is that they have really beautiful architecture and gorgeous buildings. I think this is definitely something worth mentioning because there are so many historical buildings in Barcelona, and especially if you're visiting El Gòtic, the Gothic neighborhood, there's a lot of really, really old buildings, a lot of museums as well that you can go check out, and there's just so much to see. And just walking around the city and seeing all these different neighborhoods and these really gorgeous buildings, that's already a really good experience to have in Barcelona. And of course we need to mention that in Barcelona there's a lot of buildings designed by architect Antoni Gaudi, for example Sagrada Familia. So Barcelona is a fun city. There's so much you can do and see in Barcelona. You'll definitely find something you enjoy doing and you'll definitely have a great time there. Barcelona is filled with different neighborhoods with different vibes and different restaurants and a lot of beaches and also some really nice viewing points where you can go and view the city from, such as Bonqueres del Carmel and Tibidabo. So even though there are some cons about Barcelona, but I think there are cons and like the negative stuff about every place, still Barcelona is a great city. I love Barcelona. I loved living in Barcelona and I had a really great experience there. I think there are so many things to do in Barcelona and so many different neighborhoods, places to eat, places to stay. You know, I think Barcelona has something for everyone. Barcelona is of course very different from Finland, like the food, the culture, the weather, everything is very different from Finland, but I did enjoy my time in Barcelona and I definitely recommend you to visit Barcelona as well if you haven't already. But let me know in the comments if you have already visited Barcelona and what you think are the worst and the best parts about the city. And if you haven't visited Barcelona, would you like to visit it? Let me know. So guys, that was all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and I will see you next week. Bye!